Hey, I'm Neely, and today we're talking about creating user-generated content. And with me is the expert, Emma. Hey, Emma.
Hey, Justin, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Awesome. So I have no idea what user-generated content is. Give me the lowdown. What's it about?
All right. So it gets its name, user-generated, because of how it comes to inception.
Okay.
It's created not by the brand or the business itself, but by really anyone else other than the brand. So it could be created by your biggest fans, your customers.
Okay.
It could be social media posts, photos, mentions from your employees. And then it acts as word of mouth, right? So instead of the brand always talking about their brand, their product, their service, rather it's the customer or the employee or just a fan in general. So that's what it is.
All right, so I understand what it is, but why does it matter?
Yeah, so great question. It matters because it gives an authentic view of your business. Because you as a business, you could say great things about yourself all day.
Right, I'm awesome.
Exactly. Whereas if your customers tell me, Justin Neely is awesome, he is the best, I'm going to believe that. And consumers do. Consumers believe recommendations from strangers. They believe more than friends and more than you, the business. So it helps to get a very accurate representation of what you can offer, provide as a business.
How do I get them to start creating user-generated content?
How do you get it? A way to get more of that is, for example, let's say, have you ever received a good Yelp review or a good Google review?
Yeah, all the time.
Great. So you can take that great Yelp review, post it on Instagram.
Okay.
So just quote it, maybe use Canva to make it look pretty.
I love Canva.
And that will encourage all your Instagram followers to, oh, wow, they reposted that customer's great review. I want this cool brand to repost me.
Right.
So I'm going to mention them or review them. And then that gives you an opportunity to get more user-generated content. Another way I've seen local businesses do it successfully is through a dedicated hashtag.
Okay. What I've seen businesses do, and it makes sense now, is encourage others to tag their business.
Yeah.
Like when they do an Instagram post,
Oh, totally. They
tag businesses. So that's kind of the same thing?
Same thing. And, you know, I see it, for example, I travel a lot for GoDaddy Social and I go to trade shows. And when I'm walking the floor of the trade show, there's thousands of people there. But one thing that you'll see all over that floor is they will have their hashtag, their social handles. Why?
They want user-generated content.
They want user-generated content. There's thousands.
I'm getting it.
You get it. There's thousands of attendees. The show is so busy running the show. Let the participants, the attendees, create the content. So they can essentially sit back and focus on just running the show.
Right.
And then what's going to happen is all the attendees are going to create the content because they've mentioned them. And then now you have something to repurpose. And then if I'm curious about that trade show or that local business, I'm seeing it from an authentic view.
Right. So we got all this user-generated content. What about, I've heard this term float around a lot of influencers and how influencers create that user-generated content. What's the deal with that?
Yeah, so there's actually, it's such a phenomenon that now influencers exist, which means some people live off of this. They're paid to represent a brand. So what they'll do, they'll go create content and then, of course, tag the brand, whether that's for skateboards or clothing or sunglasses
or coffee.
And then what they do is they're getting that brand in front of their audience. So influencers usually already have a pretty extensive following.
Yeah.
So then that brand, for cheaper than like a commercial or hiring an official model, they can get in front of a large audience. Tens of thousands of people through this influencer that, in a way, like we can relate to more than a famous person.
Right.
Now, you do need to follow some FTC guidelines. So it's really important if you're going to use a photo that your customer took and you repost it to your Instagram, make sure you give them credit. You use their username. You ask them if it's okay. If they're mentioning your business, pretty sure it's going to be okay. They are looking for that exposure.
Yeah.
But it's a good measure. Do follow the guidelines of asking, and then again, giving them that credit in your caption, for example.
Perfect. Makes perfect sense.
All right. That's a wrap. Thanks for joining in. It was exciting to teach you more about user-generated content. If you do have questions, be sure to comment below. And if you haven't already, subscribe to our YouTube channel. See ya.
Wait. Do you want to create some user-generated content right now?
Right now?
Right now.
Hashtag GoDaddy Life.
Hashtag GoDaddy Life. Let's do it.